Good evening and welcome to Coach World TV. I'm Terry Yoffe, and tonight my guest is Jennifer Loftus. Hi, Jennifer.
Hi, Terry.
How are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you. It's a pleasure to be on the show.
It's always a pleasure. Jennifer and I actually met about 2 years ago, she reminded me, and we've become fast friends and kind of professional buddies.
Yes.
If we will.
Absolutely.
And tonight, Jennifer is the president of HR New York, and we're going to talk a little bit about that and let her talk a little bit about what it's like being president of HR New York and explaining exactly what that is.
HRNY is the New York City chapter of the Society for Human Resource Management, or SHRM. And here in New York City, we have close to 2,000 members who belong to HRNY. And they're primarily human resource practitioners, so that could be an HR generalist, a HR manager, VP, and we have some vendor or members or consultant members like yourself and myself. And we are doing lots of exciting new things this year. So it's a good time to be a member of HRNY.
Yes, and one of the more exciting things we did, actually, is we had International Coach Week with ICF Global, and one of the events was we did a joint venture with HR New York and ICF, whereby we did some laser coaching. We invited HR New York members to come and have a taste of what coaching really is. And we had ICF NYC coaches, and we had some HR New York coaches, and it turned out to be quite a lot of fun. So tell us a little bit about your experience and what you saw.
Sure. Well, the laser coaching event, that was the first time in our history that I know of that we've done anything like that. And I'm so thankful that you came to me right around holidays and said, International Coaching Week is coming. We need to do something, and let's get the coaching out to the people. And throughout my first term here as president of HRNY, my goal has been to try new things with the chapter, and so that fit in perfectly with that goal. And very quickly, we pulled together so many individuals from ICF New York, who in many cases were also members of HRNY, to communicate and to share with people the experience of coaching in a very focused 20-30 minute segment. And the turnout that we had was phenomenal. It was great to see so many individuals, HRNY members that I had never met before, come out and try something new. And for me, the best part of that evening was, well, there were two best parts, actually. First one was doing something brand new and sharing that with you. That was just so wonderful.
It was certainly a collaboration that we had, and the energy in the room, and everybody had such a really good time that we're actually looking forward to another collaboration next year when we have International Coach Week again. And ironically, what happened once we got this whole event set up was we found out at ICF NYC that ICF Global was actually going to be doing an alliance with SHRM, which is the
national organization
for HR New York. So we were ahead of the game here.
That's it. We are on the cutting edge.
We were on the cutting edge. Who knew that we would be, you know, riding the wave before anyone else did? And it was just fabulous. And
well, we are here in New York, so we are the best.
Absolutely.
And we are trying new things all the time.
We are.
And you know, that evening was so wonderful in that as our members were leaving, the energy that they had, and you could tell the passion that the coaches put into each of those individual meetings. People were leaving saying, I haven't felt like this in so long. This has been a life-changing event.
So,
and in 20 minutes, 30 minutes time. So imagine the power of having a long-term coaching relationship.
Hence the power of coaching.
Exactly.
How could it have been put more succinctly? And another wonderful thing that's happening with HR New York, if I might just kind of sprinkle it in here
of
and
course.
You can take it,
of
is they are starting a mentoring program.
Yes.
And I actually was one of the founders of a mentoring program with ONI, Advertising Women of New York, and I actually chair the mentoring committee and the program almost 14 years into when it started. And Jennifer brought a few of us folks together, and we are again collaborating on this mentoring program. I'm going to let Jennifer tell us a little bit about that as well.
Well, certainly. And the mentoring program at HRNY has been an initiative that we've tried in the past, and we've had mixed success with it. And the challenge that our chapter has faced, or one of the primary challenges, is that there are a lot of people who want a mentor. They're looking for that guidance and that expertise to help them grow professionally and personally. There were few individuals who were willing to take on the commitment of being a mentor. And so, of course, you know, if you've got five people willing to mentor someone and 100 people who want to be mentored, you've got an imbalance there.
That's exactly true. So, and that's something that we have found at ONI, where we get so many mentees that want to, and then a little less mentors. And in the last couple of years, we have actually paired over 100 mentees and mentors.
100?
Over, for each group.
Oh my gosh. Well, so you give us something to strive for here.
Yeah, and it's such a rewarding program. And more organizations are actually looking to do mentoring programs. I have personally gotten calls from organizations that have asked me to help them look at how can they put a mentoring program together. I think with today's challenging times and in the marketplace, people want to set things up where there is relationship and there is a sense of community.
Absolutely. And based on conversations that I've been having with HR practitioners and reading the literature, mentoring is one of the quote-unquote hot topics of the day, where we're realizing that in a service-based economy like we're in, it's not so much, you know, what kind of work are you doing, but what are those networks you have, what are the relationships, and how do we transfer knowledge from one person to another without having that formal classroom setting, if you will. So mentoring is a huge part of an individual's own learning and development, particularly in these challenging economic times where budgets have been slashed.
And it's also, you know, if you have a mentor that's willing to really give their time to helping these younger professionals, really help them on their professional journey, it's so rewarding for both parties. And if the matches and the pairing is really done well, it can be so fabulous. I had a mentee for a couple of years, and I just got an amazing note from her thanking me for what I worked with her on and how much it did for her and how grateful she was. And she even had a gift for me. And it was like I have never in all my years of mentoring that someone has really taken the time to write something so wonderful. It tugs at my heart.
And your microphone.
And my microphone, exactly. And it is just really, there are no words to really tell you. So tell us a little bit about how you are foreseeing the mentoring program with HR New York.
Sure. Well, for this calendar year, 2011, we're launching the mentoring program as a pilot, because we want to make sure that it is successful. Our members have told us time and again they want this program. We went through an extensive branding study last year, and mentoring was at the top of the list. This is what we need. So we want to do this right and make it a lasting program that will be successful. And thanks to your sage insight and guidance along the way, we believe we are on the path. So our deadline for accepting applications into the program, either as a mentor or mentee, is coming up this Friday, the 25th, I believe that is. And at that point, then our committee will be getting back together and doing that pairing, looking at whose skill set will complement whose needs and facilitating that those linkages between the exclusive mentor-mentee pairs. And we'll kick off the program.
It's really important to try to pair, although you never always can get a perfect match.
Of course.
To really try to match them in ways that they have outlined that they want. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't.
Well, who's that's
to
with
say,
people.
You know, there's an expression, who's to say what's good and who's to say what's bad? Mm-hmm. And we have had many mismatches where people initially have said, this person, this mentor isn't right for me.
Really?
And then we go back and we say, why don't you, you know, give it a little time.
Try.
Get together.
Right.
Don't look at the outside. See what they can bring. Mm-hmm. And they'll come back and say, yep, we worked it out and it's great.
Wow.
And the collaboration is great. And they go on to have a very successful mentorship.
Wow. So that's an additional learning and development experience right there. Mm-hmm. Working and finding a partner who at first you would think this isn't going to work and growing from there.
Well, the thing is, there's no choice.
Because
if it doesn't
as
work,
with many things in life,
if it doesn't work, they're just out of luck because we at Orny don't have backups.
Mm-hmm.
If it doesn't work and you can't figure out how to make it work, then you don't get to have a pair.
Mm-hmm.
And our belief is that you can always find something in someone that can give you guidance, wisdom, knowledge, insights. And some people just, you know, they immediately look at the person and look at maybe their background and think, this person can help me.
Yes, because I am in pharmaceutical, therefore I only want to talk with someone who's in pharmaceutical, for example.
And once they get to meet with them and talk to them, you know, everyone can give leadership expertise or insights into the business world or insights into negotiating or how to deal.
Right.
You don't have to be in a specific industry. Mm-hmm. You know, there are many skill sets that one can offer that kind of go
cross over.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Cross over different arenas, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
So we're all very excited about the mentoring program and to see how it shapes and turns out. Luckily, it's only a pilot.
Yes.
And it's going to go from when?
Well, it's a 6-month pilot, so we're going to launch the program May 1st. Well, hopefully we'll have a kickoff meeting or a kickoff breakfast, something where the mentors and the mentees can come together.
And that's powerful.
Meet each other, in an exclusive setting. And then, so it'll run for 6 months, so through November. Mm-hmm. And then at the end, we will, of course, have a debrief, find out what worked, what didn't.
That's great.
That way, when we launch the full year program in January of 2012, we'll have
and hopefully you'll get a lot more people coming into the fold.
That's the goal.
And seeing the value of it. It does take time.
Oh, of course. And that's been our track record with HRNY as well. You have some of the early adopters who say, yes, I want to get in here and do this. And then others who kind of lay back and say, well, let's see. I'm not sure if this is for me. And then when they see, hey, this is a cool program, I need to get here. Mm. And that's where we grow to the 100 you have.
It does. It did not happen when we started at 97. Who knew that it would evolve into what it is today?
Wow.
Really, we had no clue, and it started small, and it built and built and built, and I think in the 4 years that I have been either chair or we had a co-chair, we have really grown the program with the type of ideas and events that we're bringing to it to keep it alive and keep it valuable.
Keep it fresh.
Yeah,
yes.
And there's always some where it doesn't work out, and that's just the way it is.
We do what we can. We can't please everyone all of the time, unfortunately.
Right.
We would like to do
that's
that.
That's true. That is true. So, Jennifer, in your real life,
HRNY isn't real?
Well, in the flip side of what you do professionally, tell us a little bit about Astron Solutions, which is the company that Jennifer is part of.
Sure. Well, Astron Solutions, I'm a founding partner and national director of the firm. And we are a compensation and human resource consulting firm headquartered here in New York City. And in terms of our business, we primarily have four different service lines that we provide. First being traditional compensation consulting, and that sounds very jargony. Mm. Plain English, what that means is we help companies, nonprofit organizations, figure out how much should they pay their employees.
Mm.
There is a science behind what goes into a paycheck, whether it's somebody's hourly wage, or a sales commission, or a bonus, or an incentive plan, and we have the science cookbooks, if you will, behind the scenes and the expertise to make that work in so many different types of organizations.